I'm Blake X, and this is another nuclear reaction. What's up, survivors? So this is a special bonus reaction. So you'll be getting, whatever day I upload this, you'll be getting two reactions in one day. And this one is going to be another uranium reaction, because I haven't done those in a while. If you don't know, there are other types of reactions besides just the regular ones that I do on this channel. Now, primarily, I react to metal songs or to other music, and that's always the main thing that I will be doing on this channel. Other types of reactions that I do have are radioactive reactions, where I'll just pick a random song on a metal radio station and listen to that. There are also meta reactions, where I react to someone else reacting to something. And there are also uranium reactions, which is usually me reacting to something that is not quite music, and usually it's something that's pop culture related. It could be a movie trailer, it could be a full episode of something, a clip from a documentary, you know, whatever, but in that general category. So that's what I'm going to be doing today, because the new trailer just dropped last night, apparently, for The Mandalorian, which is a kind of like a spin-off of Star Wars. It's a Star Wars TV series, essentially, that's going to premiere on Disney+. I'm sure all you guys know about that, anyone who's interested in watching this. And I'm not sure how I feel about the idea of it. If you guys watched my reaction for the Star Wars trailer that's coming out, for the movie that's coming out, I should say, for The Rise of Skywalker, and you listened to my commentary in that reaction video, you know that I have some reservations about this new Star Wars series and the direction that it's been heading in. You know that I really didn't enjoy The Last Jedi much at all. I really didn't care for the Han Solo movie. So I kind of have my doubts, my reservations about Star Wars in general going forward. And I feel like my excitement for the upcoming new film is dwindling, you know, little by little. But I am slowly kind of warming up to the idea of this whole Disney Plus thing. You know, Disney's streaming service where they're going to have a lot of Marvel shows and a lot of Star Wars spinoffs. I initially thought that it was just going to be the Rogue One prequel that they were talking about and this, The Mandalorian. But now I'm hearing about an Obi-Wan series. I'm hearing about other plans they have for additional series based off Star Wars. And then there's the whole Marvel series. There's what, WandaVision, Falcon, and what was it? Falcon and Winter Soldier. Some particular ones I actually am kind of excited about or interested in, like the Ms. Marvel series, She-Hulk. Those things kind of just came out of the blue and I wasn't expecting them to be announced. So maybe I really will check out some of these shows. Probably not all of them. Like, I'm not too excited for the Loki series. I'm not sure if I'll be watching the Falcon and the Winter Soldier. I'm not sure how I feel about that. Those two characters were never among my favorites out of the films. But maybe I'll give the Disney Plus thing a try. And maybe I'll give this TV show a shot. Also, the Obi-Wan series seems interesting to me. So I'll keep an open mind, as I always do, and see what this trailer has to offer, and see what kind of tone they're going for, what's going to happen in this new series, see how much that it reveals. So with that being said, I think we're just going to get into it. But first, I just want to mention that there is a Patreon now for Nuclear Reactions, patreon.com/nuclearreactions. There are different tiers. And depending on which tier you get on, you get different benefits, different exclusive content, including unreleased reaction videos that you'll never see on this channel, other video clips, polls that you could vote in, discount codes for the merch store, which, by the way, is Ye Olde Nuclear Shop, and the link to that is in the description. And also in the description is the link to the official Facebook group for Nuclear Reactions, which is the Mushroom Cloud, and you can join that if you want to. You can also support me on Patreon if you want, no pressure. You can become a patron for as low as $2 a month. So, you know, if it's something you're interested in and if you want to show your support for the channel and be a part of the nuclear family in another way and an exciting way that offers you access to exclusive things, that's one way to do it. So just throwing that out there for anyone interested. All right, The Mandalorian official trailer. I think I've rambled on enough, so let's get to this. I'm hearing some big names, too, that are in this, some big actors, so we'll have to see how this trailer is. All right, let's check it out. 3, 2, 1, go. Stormtroopers. Heads on pikes, huh? A little dark for Star Wars. Thank you. really nicely shot, though. Film quality.
Bounty hunting is a complicated profession.
Ah, carbonate.
Don't you agree?
November 12th. Wow. Sooner than I expected. Okay, that was the Mandalorian official trailer. Really looks... I'm kind of split on it. It looks very interesting. Looks very action-packed. It looks a little bit dark, especially for Star Wars. And it looks like it has sort of a... maybe a bit of a Western vibe, given the imagery that I saw and the kind of tone that they seem to be going for. So very interesting, that's for sure. I'll probably give it a shot. I'd be surprised if I didn't watch at least one or two episodes of this to see if I like it and if I stick with it. And anyway, a lot of the shows that are my main shows that I watch are going to be ending in 2020. So that'll free up some time for me to find new shows to check out. So, you know, maybe I will give this streaming service a chance when it debuts. But yeah, so my main criticism that I've had recently with Star Wars, some of the newer movies that have come out in recent years, is that I think that the thing that made the trilogy a really great thing was that it really had good chemistry with its characters, and it really had a lot of heart in it. And for some reason, the newer movies have been lacking that. Rogue One, I enjoyed various aspects of it, but to me, it didn't have good chemistry between the characters. It didn't have a feeling of heart, a feeling that you can connect yourself with the characters in the film in any way. The Force Awakens seemed to start off strong, and it seemed like they were really building towards something with Rey and Rey's character. But then when they went to The Last Jedi, it seems like that all went out the window. That's how it felt to me. And they kind of divided up the main characters, which was to me, a very poor creative decision. And then they tried to basically shoehorn in all these additional characters that I just felt were not fully developed. Some of them not developed at all. And characters that I didn't particularly care about. You know, there are characters in that movie that I can't even remember their names because they were so forgettable. So, you know, I was not a fan of that movie, and I feel like Star Wars has lost its touch ever since it got into the hands of Disney. Even the prequel movies, I know everyone hates them. I myself actually liked Revenge of the Sith. The first two I wasn't crazy about, but even the prequel movies, they still had a feeling of emotion in them, and the characters still had a chemistry between them. Say what you will about the actor that played Anakin, but he and the actor that played Obi-Wan had a very excellent chemistry, both in Attack of the Clones and Revenge of the Sith. And I thought that was very well done. So even though the movies themselves may not have been great, you know, and especially in comparison with the original trilogy, of course, they still had little elements in them that you could enjoy or appreciate or respect. Whereas the sequel trilogy that they have now, it just seems like it's falling flat, you know. Kylo Ren, to me, is a very ineffectual, forgettable kind of villain. Definitely no Darth Vader. And, you know, I just feel like there's also not a lot of originality in the new trilogy. It seems like they're just kind of piggybacking off of old ideas and recycling old ideas and old characters. You know, it just seems like more of the same. And I wish they would bring something new to the table. Now, this could be a case of that, where they inject a little bit of originality and creativity back into the Star Wars franchise. It definitely looks interesting. They had some interesting droids in there, interesting scenes, interesting characters. Some excellent actors in this, like Giancarlo Esposito, who played that character in Breaking Bad. I'm definitely intrigued, for sure. And this is definitely very well shot. The cinematography looks great. This is like movie quality, even though it's a TV series. So I'm almost positive they'll be checking out at least the first episode. And I'll really give this one a chance. I'm curious to see if they can turn around, you know, the direction that Star Wars has been heading in. But, you know, even when I saw the trailer for Rise of Skywalker, I thought about it for a while, and over the course of several months, in fact. And I was just saying this the other day, but it really feels like Like, the whole thing with bringing the Emperor back, it feels like they know that they kind of screwed up with their villains that they've had in the sequel trilogy, with Kylo Ren, with Snoke. Snoke, in my opinion, was a disaster. I mean, he had no backstory, really no relation to the plot at all. They really didn't explain anything at all with him. And then he was just, like, you know, randomly killed, which was supposed to be, like, a surprising plot twist, but really it just fell flat. Because, again, no one cared about the character. No one knew anything about the character. So when he was killed in The Last Jedi, it didn't really land with the emotional or the narrative impact that I think the director was hoping for. So there's that. So I feel like bringing the Emperor back is almost like an apology for having, you know, such one-dimensional or uninteresting characters in this trilogy. I also think it's a mistake, though. You know, to me, it's like the final demonstration that they don't know what they're doing with these movies. You know, I don't know. I mean, maybe they'll make it work. Maybe the twist will be earned. You know, maybe there'll be a good reason for why and how he comes back. I honestly don't know. But the whole thing with Disney obtaining Star Wars, I don't know how I feel about it. I think that I'm kind of disappointed, to be honest, because, you know, they threw out the whole Star Wars expanded universe. They took that and threw it out the window because they had to make these new movies. So that is all no longer canon, you know. All those novels and everything like that, like the Thrawn trilogy, for example. Those were three very good novels, and I really enjoyed reading those, and I still enjoy them. I have to get the other two. I have a copy of the third one, but not the first two. But anyway, like stuff like that, like that's all no longer canonical with the, you know, main Star Wars universe. So, you know, that's a little bit saddening to me. All that time and all that investment that all these writers put into the Star Wars story just is now meaningless, you know, according to Disney anyway. So, and I know that they're establishing and creating their own expanded universe and stuff like this, like the Mandalorian and the Obi-Wan series. That's, you know, proof of that. And that's, you know, but even that, you know, it's like they're taking established characters and kind of just, you know, stretching it out into longer stories and longer story arcs. There's so much new stuff they could be focusing on. Or they could even do something in the Old Republic, you know, in that timeline. They could be doing something with like a really different type of race of aliens, like the Yuuzhan Vong, which when they were introduced into the Star Wars universe, that was like completely different from what had already been established. So things like that are examples of really good series they can make and things that I would be interested in seeing. That being said, I am interested in this and I will check it out. And especially the Obi-Wan series, I think I'll give that one a shot too, just because I really like that actor and I think he did a good job playing the character. So I will give that one a chance as well. The Rogue One prequel series, I'm not too excited about that one. I think I might skip that, but I'll have to see. You know, if it gets good reviews and there's a lot of buzz around it, maybe I'll check it out. But this trailer, you know, again, it felt like a Western to a certain degree. It felt a little bit excessively dark for Star Wars. Not that I don't like that, but I just think, I'm kind of thinking, is that right for the franchise? You know, is that right for this universe? But, you know, they kind of did that with the Han Solo movie, too. Like it was a lot grittier and darker than, for example, the original trilogy or the prequel trilogy. So it remains to be seen what tone they'll have in this. But the trailer makes me think that it's going to have a similar tone to something like the Solo movie. So I'll have to see if I end up liking the characters. Should be interesting to see whether the main character ever takes off his helmet. And whether or not they could write some interesting and compelling stories within this universe here. So, very, very interesting at the very least. And, you know, I'll be interested to see what the future holds for the whole Disney Plus thing, for all these Marvel shows, for all these Star Wars shows. I really hope that they don't kill or hurt the franchise. I really hope that these series and their stories and the characters in them feel earned and not just, you know, convoluted. So we'll have to wait and see. Only two more months, pretty much, because this all starts in November. So I am looking forward to it. I have my reservations, but I'm looking forward to it all the same. So there you have it, my analysis and my reaction to the Mandalorian official trailer. And if you're not into this kind of reaction, then don't worry, because there are plenty more music and especially metal reactions coming on this channel and plenty more items from the infinite list that you requested. So that's pretty much it. Thanks for watching, guys. Thanks for the support. Thanks for subscribing. If you haven't subscribed yet, please do. And I will catch you guys on the next one.